Well, hello there, smarty birds. Are you ready for a fun science experiment? Today, we're going to be making a papier-mâché volcano that actually erupts. So, here are the supplies you'll need to gather up.
Thanks, Gary. Okay, are you ready for this craft? This is a big one. You'll need a 1-liter bottle, 3 cups of water, and we're gonna need a lot of paint. You can use any colors, but we'll be using gray, light blue, white, dark blue, and purple to mimic Eagle Island. Next, we'll need 1 cup of flour, 4 tablespoons of baking soda, 1 tablespoon of dish soap, 2 cups of vinegar, a funnel, a pitcher, red and yellow food coloring, a paintbrush, and a cutting tool such as scissors or a utility knife. Phew, that's a lot. And you'll also need a large piece of cardboard, masking tape, a whole lot of newspaper, and a mixing bowl. Don't forget your measuring cups.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that.
We're gonna be using a cup and a tablespoon today. Make sure to have a grown-up ready to help if you get stuck.
We need to work together.
If I'm moving too fast, you can always stop and rewind. Might wanna pause now and go get the stuff if you haven't already. I'll wait. Yep, still waiting. I get it, it's a lot of stuff. Ready? Me too. Here we go. First, lay down some cardboard. If you want your volcano to look like Zeta's, you'll need to fold your newspaper like this to create a wedge for the bottle to rest on. Then, stick the wedge to the cardboard with your masking tape. Next, position your 1-liter bottle on the wedge and secure it with tape. Then, crumple some of the newspaper into balls about the size of your fist. Arrange them around the bottle, building it up to form the base of your icy mountain. Ooh, brr. I'm getting cold just thinking about it. Then, use masking tape to keep those newspaper balls in place. Don't want them getting away. Now it's time to create your papier-mâché paste. Pour in your flour and water. Mix it up with your hands to get all those little clumps out. Then, rip and dip a strip of newspaper into the mixture. Lightly slide your finger down the strip to get rid of any extra paste. Slimy. Then, apply the strip to your volcano. Repeat this process as many times as necessary, working your way around the base. Once you've covered the whole structure, feel free to go back and add extra strips. The more layers you have, the easier it'll be to decorate. Phew. I don't know about you, but I'm tired. Ah! Let's take a break and let this dry overnight. In the morning, you can have a grown-up help you cut off excess cardboard with your cutting tool. Now that it's all dry, what do you say we add some color? Grab your paintbrush and some white paint to give yourself a nice clean slate to work on. You may need several coats to cover it completely. Once the white paint is dry, it's time to get creative. Use the rest of your paint to decorate your volcano. You can make it like the movie or do your own thing.
It is glorious!
Now it's time for the explosively fun part. Place your pitcher on a flat surface. Mix your last cup of water, baking soda, and dish soap, and add some food coloring to get your perfect lava color. Place the funnel into the top of your volcano, then pour the baking soda mixture inside. Phew! Now take a deep breath. It's time! I can barely contain my excitement! Okay, take your cup of vinegar and pour it into the volcano until it erupts!
It actually worked!
Yes, yes, yes!
Let's see that in slow motion.
Pretty amazing, right? Science is the coolest! Now, be sure to clean up after your experiment. Wouldn't want your parents to erupt.